Hello, this is Sherline of Kathanika, and today I'm going to tell you a story. Now, this story is a folktale from Maharashtra, and it is about a mahatari. A mahatari is an old lady. Now, once many years ago, there lived a mahatari. She lived in a small cottage at the bottom of a hill. On the top of the hill lived the old lady's daughter. Now, the old lady's daughter was an excellent cook. She used to make delicious things to eat and delicious things to drink. And the old lady, the mahatari, she used to climb up the hill and go to her daughter's house and have all those yummy, yummy food that the daughter used to make. Now, one day, the old lady got up early in the morning. She went into her kitchen and she saw, "Arey, there's nothing nice to eat today at home." This means one thing and one thing only. Why don't I go up the hill to my daughter's house? She would have surely cooked something nice. So I'm going to go up to her house and I'm going to have something yummy to eat. So the old lady, the mahatari, she tightened her nawari sari. She took a shawl on her shoulders. She took up her walking stick and she exited her house. She locked the door and she began walking up and climbing up the hill. She put down her walking stick, thapak, 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 and she started walking up the hill. Now, between the old lady's house and her daughter's house on the top of the hill was a dense, thick jungle. And in that jungle, there lived different kinds of animals, rabbits, deer, monkeys, snakes, and also different kynds of birds, mynas, bulbuls, flycatchers, different types of birds, and insects too. The old lady, she was a very courageous old lady. She used to not get scared for all these animals. She used to walk. And on this day, as she entered the jungle, she found it got a little dark. Because the trees were growing close together and there was hardly any sunlight penetrating down. So the old lady, she kept her eyes wide open. She kept her ears wide open. And she tightened her grip on her stick and she put it down, thapak, 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 and she walked into the forest. Now, as she walked into the forest, she heard some sound from behind a bush. The old lady stopped. She listened and suddenly from behind that bush jumped out in front of her an animal. Oh, it was grey in colour. It had a long snout and on that snout there was a small damp nose, pointy ears and a big bushy tail. And the animal said, "Aww!
Hey, mahatari, hey, old lady, where are you going, huh? I'm hungry and I'm going to eat you."
Are babre. You know what animal it was? It was the wolf. Wolf is called langa in Marathi. The old lady got scared, but she didn't show it. She was very courageous. So she looked at the wolf and she laughed. And she said,
"Are langa ba wolfi. Oh, you want to eat me? Why not? You can eat me. But, you know, if you eat me now, I'm only skin and bones. I'm so thin. But I'm going to go to my daughter's house and I'm going to eat lovely things and I'm going to drink lovely things and I'm going to become nice and plump and fat. And then when I come back down, then you can eat me." And she said this in Marathi. She said, "मी लेकीकडे जाते, चार दिवस राहते, तूप भाकर खाते, जाडजूड होते, मग तू मला खा." Now the wolf thought this was a brilliant idea. "अरे वा, good, good. Very nice, old lady. Go up the hill, become nice and fat and come back this way. I'm waiting here." "Of course, sure," said the old lady. And she said, "Bye, bye, wolfie." And she took her stick and before the wolf could change his mind, she quickly put her steps down, tapak, 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 and she climbed up the hill.
And as she was going up the hill, she again heard some sound and then jumped out of at her a big creature. Ore bapre, he was black in color. He had small eyes, small ears, and one chotu sa tail, and it said, "Growl! Hey, old lady, where are you going?"
"I'm hungry and I'm going to eat you today."
You know what animal it was? It was a bear. And bear is called what in Marathi? Aswal. The old lady was scared. But did she show it? No. She looked at the bear and she laughed.
Are Aswal bua. Oh ho, bear. You want to eat me? Of course you can eat me. But look at me. I'm all skin and bones. If you eat me now, you won't get any flesh.
But I'm going to my daughter's house, who lives on the top of the hill. And she is going to give me nice things to eat and drink. And I'm going to become nice and fat. And then when I come down, then you can eat me. She said it in Marathi. She said, "Mi leki kade zate, char divas rate, tu bhakar khate, zaad zood hote, mag tumala kha." Now the bear thought, "Areva, this is a good idea. Okay, old lady, go quickly, become nice and fat and come back right this way. I'm waiting here for you."
Of course, bye bye, Berry," said the old lady.
And tapuk tapuk, tupuk tapuk, tupuk tapuk. She put down a stick and she started walking fast, fast, fast up the hill. And she started thinking, "Arey, what, all these animals are very hungry and want to eat me today. Let me reach my daughter's house quickly." And she had almost reached her daughter's house when a third animal jumped in front of her.
"Hey, old lady, where are you going?" "I'm going to eat you today."
"Arey, babre, this animal," he said. And he was orange and black in color. Do you know what it was? Tiger. And tiger is called what in Marathi? Waghoba, wag. Old lady was scared. Babre, it was a tiger. But she was very courageous. She looked at the tiger and she laughed.
"Oh, Waghoba, oh, tigey, waigey. You want to eat me? Of course you can eat me. But look at me. I'm all skin and bones. If you eat me now, there is no flesh at all. But I'll tell you what. I'm going to my daughter's house. And she's going to make lovely things to eat and drink. And I'm going to become nice and plump. And then I'll come back this way. And then, tiger, then you can eat me." Now the tiger thought this was a good plan. "Okay, old lady, that is really nice. But make sure you come back this way, huh? I'm waiting here." Old lady said, "Pakka, sure, I'm coming right this way." And she put down her stick. Tapuk, tapak, tupuk, tapak, tupuk, tapak. She said, "Let me, Baba, reach my daughter's house before somebody else catches me." And tap, tup, tap, tup, tap, tup, tap, tup. She reached her daughter's house. She reached there and she knocked at the door. Her daughter opened the door. She said, "Are, aai, mother, how lovely to see you. Come in, come in, come in." So the old lady went inside. She locked the door and she sat down and she said, "Ah, I'm so hungry. What have you prepared?" So the daughter said, "Ah, I've prepared lots of things. I've prepared pohe. I've prepared thalipeet. I have prepared misal pav. I have prepared, what else? Kande bhaji. What do you want to eat?" So the old lady said, "All of this is nice. But have you made that special soup that I like very much?" So the daughter said, "Aha, pumpkin soup. Yes, I have made that." Old lady said, "Yummy, my mouth is watering. Please, please, give me soon." So the lady went inside, the daughter went inside, and she got a nice big bowl of bubbling hot pumpkin soup. The old lady put some nice pepper and salt, and she started drinking the soup. "Array, my daughter, this is so yummy. How lovely. Can I have a little more?" "Sure," said the daughter, "why not?" And she filled the bowl again. Old lady hungrily drank it up. "Ah, that was so nice. My tummy is nice and full. Thank you, my daughter. I knew I would find something nice in your house. Ah, now I'm feeling good. And now I think I should go back to my house." "Now only? Wait, now, sit for some time. You've just come. Why don't you stay for some time and go?"
No, no, said the old lady. I have to go home. I have lots of work to do. So I'm going to go. So the old lady, she took her walking stick and she almost stepped out of the house when she remembered. She said, Arre, oh, 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 oh. Her daughter said, what happened? She said, oh, what to tell you. Today there were lots of animals on the road. There were like 3 animals who are waiting to eat me. There is a tiger and there is a bear and there's a wolf and they are waiting to eat me. Now, how will I go home safe? Come on, daughter, you're such a clever girl. Can you think of a way so that I can reach my home safe and sound without these animals eating me? The daughter said, oh, let me look around, let me think. And the daughter looked here and she looked there around her house. And then she saw her great big pumpkin shell. And she said to her mother, she said, Aayi, if you can manage to squeeze and sit inside this pumpkin shell, then I can roll you down. I can roll, give the pumpkin a push and it will roll down the hill and you'll reach home. And the animals may not eat you. Okay, so said the old lady, that's a great idea. And the old lady, she squeezed this way and that way and this way and that way and sat down in the pumpkin shell. And she took her walking stick also behind. It was a great big pumpkin shell. The old lady could fit in. And then the daughter, she put the lid of that pumpkin. She sealed it with wax and she took a stick and she made holes in the pumpkin lid so that the old lady could breathe inside. And then she said, okay, Aayi, are you ready? And the old lady said, yes, yes, I'm ready. And the daughter, she rolled the pumpkin and took it to the door. And from there, she gave it a nice push. And the pumpkin started rolling, rolling, rolling down the hill. Now, as the pumpkin rolled, our old lady, who was a very jolly old lady, she started singing a song to encourage the pumpkin to roll faster. And she said, Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. Can you sing with me? Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. Chal re means come on. Bhopla means pumpkin. Tunuk tunuk is just a sing song phrase. Yeah. Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. And the pumpkin started rolling and rolling and rolling and rolling and dabak. It came and bumped against the third animal, which was the tiger. And the tiger growled, Hey, Bhoplya, hey, pumpkin, where are you rolling and going, huh? And what is this? I can smell the old lady. Did you see the old lady anywhere, huh, Bhoplya? And the old lady who was sitting inside the pumpkin shell, she said, What old lady are you talking about? I don't know. I'm just a pumpkin. I'm just rolling down. The tiger said, Are you sure? And the old lady said, Yes, yes, there is no old lady. She said in Marathi, Matari bittari mala nahi mahit. And then the pumpkin started rolling and she said, Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. And the pumpkin rolled, 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 rolled and dabak. It went and banged against the second creature, which was the bear, which was the aswal. The aswal stopped the pumpkin. Hey, 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 Bhoplya, where are you roaming, huh? And did you see that old lady anywhere? I can smell her, but I can't see her. And the old lady sitting inside, she said, I don't know what old lady you're talking about. I'm just a pumpkin and I'm just rolling. Now, if you let me move away a little, I want to roll down. And the old lady, she said, Matari bittari mala nahi mahit. Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. And the bear let the pumpkin go. And the pumpkin began rolling. And it rolled and rolled and rolled and rolled and Da-bang! It bumped into the first creature, which was the wolf. And the wolf said, Ow! Hey, pumpkin. Hey, Bhoplya. Huh? Where are you rolling? And have you seen that old lady, the Mahatari Disli Kare Kuthe? Have you seen that old lady anywhere? Old lady was sitting inside and she said, Mahatari Bittari Malanahi Mait. Chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk kare, chal re bhoplya tunuk tunuk. But the wolf, Oh, he was a smart one. You couldn't fool the wolf. He said, wait, 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 wait. Hey, Bhopliya, thumb, thumb, thumb. Huh? You smell like a old lady, and I'm very sure you taste like an old lady too. And the wolf, he went round and round the pumpkin, and he started scratching at the top of the pumpkin to pry the lid open. And he scratched and he scratched and he scratched, and very soon he loosened up the lid and he popped the lid open. But the old lady, she was waiting ready with her stick. The minute the wolf put his nose inside to check who's sitting in that pumpkin, the old lady took that stick and gave a nice punch to the wolf. Bang! Dushum! Ow! Cried the wolf and ran away. The old lady, she jumped out of the pumpkin. She ran the few meters back to her home. She opened the door. She locked it, got inside, locked it behind her. And she said, oh, bop, bop, I've reached home safe. And then the old lady, she went into her kitchen and she had a nice hot cup of
tea.
Of
tea.
Of chaha. Did you like the story? Thank you.